Hi everybody, welcome to another episode of Fish Keeping Jamaica. So I went to one of my suppliers for glass. You know, whenever I'm making fish tank for persons or myself, I would go here, and they had on display this aquarium. Yes, an aquarium. It was about 3 inches. I know that's not more than 4 inches, right? Between 3 to 4 inches in thickness, and it's about four foot in length, right? They also had some other aquariums, small aquariums, placed on the desk. These were like displays. The emphasis of this video is primarily about the thickness of the glass in which you use to actually make your aquarium. Now, a lot of persons, and you'll see that on the screen a chart with regards to the recommended thickness of the glass per size tank, right? Now, you wouldn't use a very thin glass to make, like, for example, a four feet or a 6 feet tank, versus if it is like all let's say 2 foot or 3 foot in height, right? This tank, it really looks creative. It's well tight, it's well silicone and all that, but what I would fear is the fact that whenever it needs to be cleaned, there are just certain sections on this tank which will probably prove difficult for your hand to actually take up anything that you need to take up, and you know, it would look good. It would look good with some colorful small fish, right? If you get some, like, some cardinal or some neon tetra along with some danios, probably it wouldn't look good. But I probably would have problem with the filtration system, as to probably I would have to install a external sub or external filtration system, which will have a intake and an outtake, which probably might give a little problem. I am actually right now, I'm just showing you the edges as it is done in a fashionable way, in which you actually have glass, looking glass at the ends. But coming back to the whole idea of the filtration system, it would probably pose a problem to create a filtration system for this, because you have very fine fish. That means you have to take precaution in actually, you know, ensuring that the fish will not actually be taken up by the filtration system. Now, the looking glass at the side is just a creative means of, you know, putting the glass together. Interestingly, this tank, because it has so many corners, it has several brace glasses used for bracing the tank itself. I would recommend anything over 6 feet and over that you actually put better 2 or 3 brace strip across your tank, so as to help to hold the pressure as the water actually goes into the tank. What will happen is that more pressure will be placed on the seams, and you don't want the tank to actually fall apart, right? The quality of the glass also plays an important role in the construction of your tank. Now, if you have substandard glass making your tank, you'll find that the tank will not last for long. As soon as you ship it for cleaning, as soon as you ship it to relocate it within your household, you'll find that there might be an issue. Okay, many fish keepers manufacture, or should I say, make their own means of keeping their fish. They use, for example, they might use plexiglass, or I call it acrylic glass. They use acrylic glass, right? And some use actual glass itself, right? In Jamaica, in Jamaica, the use of glass is the most preferable means of making a tank. Why? Because it's much cheaper. Let's say I am looking at purchasing a sheet of, let's say that I'm looking at purchasing a sheet of plexiglass to make a very large aquarium. One sheet of glass probably might cost, when I say one sheet, I mean one entire sheet, like we call it about 6-7 foot by about 8 foot. That might cost, let's say, 40,000-50,000 Jamaican dollars divided by US. Let's say you're working somewhere in the region of, let's say, today the exchange rate in Jamaica is $125 and probably about 50-60 cents, right? So if you want to find out how much it would be in American dollars, you would have to now divide that $40,000-$50,000 by the $125.50 something cents, and then you get the idea as to the amount for the glass. But the thing is that when you're using plexiglass, the cost will either double or triple, meaning that it would be like three times that amount, right? So it would be like $140,000-$150,000 just for one sheet of plexiglass, which fish keeper will actually invest so much money in constructing a tank, right? It's just like it's rare. Okay, so the more preferable type of glass for building aquariums in Jamaica is glass itself. Okay, now as I said before, the thickness of glass, some persons practice put on braces on every single tank in which they make, right? But as I said, sometimes it's really unbugging having all that brace on your tank. Whenever you're cleaning or you're doing something in the tank, it might just come in your way. For example, this tank I'm looking at, if I should put in a certain type of filtration system in it, it might just give me a problem. Right, in looking, continuing to look at the tank structure, right, I can say that in Jamaica the average size aquarium is about 4 feet, right? You might have some persons might go up to 6 feet, 2 feet tall, 6 feet long, right? And probably about 15 inches, or in some cases you might have 16 inches wide, right? That's the average size tank. You won't have a super tank like a 8 foot or 9 foot with like 4 or 5 foot up in the air. It's just not a common practice, right? One thing though, the tanks that are available in Jamaica, right, are very creatively done. Most of the larger tanks, like for example this one I'm looking at, are imported. This is a tank that is located at one of my favorite fish store. This is a Bouffant fish tank. The front have like a sea. It looks really nice. If you look at the quality, you realize that there's lighting, the filtration system comes with it, decorations, it has a cabinet. It looks like it holds about 75 gallon water. And it has a little hole in it in which you can throw your feed in it, right? This tank comes fully stocked. The thickness of the glass is looks nice, right? And the seams are not all that messy, unlike mine, which is really messy. But I do my tanks primarily for breeding and quarantine, so the is the nature of constructing tanks right now, as it is for me, my personal tanks. It's not about beauty, it's just about ensuring that it holds. When I'm doing a tank for somebody now, then now that's a different case. Now this tank looks simple, seem neat, the height is okay. You can see that these tank over to the left, well, right in front of you now, they are imported, while the others without the thing on the top are made locally, right? Some persons just want a tank that has a cover, and the ones with the brown like covering at the top, the borders, they all come with a top. Alright, so I'm in the fish store, right? And I am looking at tanks, and I realize that several of the tanks in which I'm looking at are dusty, dirty, and just look as if they are not being sold, right? I think one of the reasons for this is that many persons opt to make their own tanks or keep their fish in non-traditional format, right? The tanks that exist within the pet shop is of total different nature than the tanks that exist in the pet shop for sale to customers, right? These tanks are purchased primarily for display, right? The fish actually have shared equal space out throughout the entire rack, right? Some fish, I think that some fish have too little bit space though. For example, the Oscar, which you don't see on the screen right now, it's somewhere else. It was on the rack, but they took it off, right? I guess this is a common situation in many. Oh, they are the Piscus bar and the silver dollar. Many persons, I guess, have the same problem with regards to the stocking of fish at local fish pet shop. These minganos look so beautiful, however, you know, it just, I think that they are, that little holding area is just overstocked. But remember, this is just a pet shop. Well, that's it for fish keeping Jamaica. I hope that this video was of interest. In summary of this video, I look at the fact that the thickness of the glass is of importance for your tank size. It makes no sense to purchase thin glass to make a large tank, which will eventually break under the pressure of water. Also, when constructing your tank, you should always bear in mind the filtration system that you will use, right? If possible, get your glass to be drilled from your purchasing, right? And also, if possible, always try to source the correct, I call it now, the covering for your tank. Thank you for making a fish keeping Jamaica. Please subscribe, share, and like, and hit that subscribe button with that bell. Bye bye. Riley here from Fish Keeping Jamaica. Irie, cool.